Well, to Canterbury Park, which is a pretty rare venue on a Saturday, but a big crowd, and we're coming into race four. And there's an old theory about class overcoming all obstacles, and I hope it applies to the favourite John Delar, who's burdened with 60 and a half kilos, Ken.
I think you'll win, John, but he's not favourite in the betting ring. He's favourite on the tote. Bookies have taken a huge set against him. You can almost get each way odds with bookies. Number one, John Delar, is 7-4 on the tote. 33 No Bugles, 9 Pleasant Express, 7 Pleasant Flight, 40 Crescidium, Whiskey George is at 5-2, he's favourite, about $3.80 now, getting out to 11-4, 66 Empress Fury, 10 Record Dash, Regal Harry is a scratching, 14 Garuna, and 8-1 Ladrone. I've stuck with John Delar, but I must confess, I backed him with the bookies. Their odds were better. Here's Johnny.
Well, that's a smart move, Kenny, and we'll see what happens. He'll be easy to see, John Delar, because he's a big, tall chestnut with a white blaze, and he's in conspicuous white and black colours with red hoop sleeves. He'll stand out like a cocktail bar in the Sahara. And he's drawn three horses in from the extreme outside of the field. Peter Cook goes up on Pleasant Flight. Starter Billy Dale coming over to release the field. And they're about set for a start in race four. Gates open, off and running, and towards the inside, Pleasant Express jump well, but the rider doesn't want a lead. Whiskey George and Record Dash go to the lead together when they get going over Garuna, followed by John Delar, who began well. Pleasant Flight is coming over from the outside into a good spot. Garuna settles down about fifth as they go to the back, and then Ladrone three deep on the first turn with Empress Fury between horses, a gap then to No Bugles. Back second last when they settle down is Pleasant Express, and last of all, Crescidium to the riverside, 1,100 metres out, and going to the lead now is Pleasant Flight, and kicked away by a length and a half to Record Dash, with Whiskey George pulling hard in third place. John Delar is travelling three wide down the back. On the fence, Garuna, followed by Empress Fury, and then Ladrone, who's last of the main bunch, and about five lengths away, the last three, Pleasant Express, Crescidium, and No Bugles. As they start the run up the hill, 700 metres out, Pleasant Flight is the leader. Record Dash second, and a half length away, Whiskey George on the outside, and then Garuna, followed by Empress Fury. John Delar three deep is only five lengths off the lead as they come up the hill, and he's starting to go forward now. On the fence, making ground, is Pleasant Express. At the head of the others, Ladrone, followed by No Bugles, and Crescidium last on the corner. Into the straight, Pleasant Flight is the leader, clear of Record Dash. In third place, Whiskey George, followed by Garuna. Now John Delar's under plenty of pressure, straightening up, and is struggling as they come to the 200 mark, and Record Dash headed Pleasant Flight. Whiskey George in third place, and now Pleasant Express, and Ladrone is starting to charge down the outside. Record Dash in front. Look at Ladrone picking him up very quickly. Record Dash in front, and he's held on to win. Record Dash by about a half neck to the fast finishing Ladrone, and very tight for third, Pleasant Express or Pleasant Flight, and then Garuna well back as No Bugles, followed by Whiskey George, John Delar, Empress Fury second last, and last of all is Crescidium. That betting market answers all questions. The winner will be Record Dash, number 8, is going to pay tote odds of $10 and $3.30. 11 Ladrone, $2.10. And third place getter, pretty close, either Pleasant Express, which was showing odds of $2.40, or Pleasant Flight showing $2.50. More coming up shortly on Wide World of Sports.
Entire fuel delivery system clean. Ordinary unleaded left these inlet ports coated with dirty carbon deposits. New Mobil F1 cleaned them up and kept them spotless. New F1 Premium Unleaded. It's made to drive your engine clean. Another reason why Mobil is the number one team.
It was 8 p.m. on a Friday,
and there was lots of planning to do. Phew, the missus was getting edgy, and I promised to see it through. I needed nails, paint, and a ladder.
And plenty of timber, too.
And next door, I'd lost my hammer.
But that was nothing new.
The day dawned, it was a beauty. I said a quick goodbye. Then driving along, we passed some blokes still getting the same old line. can't find it, what are you, blind? Now, some blokes might have been discouraged, and some blokes might have said enough, but we headed for the sign that said we've got the flaming lot. The bloke even found a smile and gave a tip or two and said, hey, you'll need this to see it through.
Beauty, mate.
Another bloke might have been discouraged. Another bloke might have said enough. But I knew to head to the sign that said we've got the flaming lot.
Might have been. You need it? I've got it.
What is this strange creature? Which princess is little Sally? If only you'd had a Pentax Zoom 60. You could zoom in for telephoto, for close-ups, even macro. Zoom out for wide angle or anything in between. So, give Rover back his legs. Give Roger his head. Give the bride a groom. Give Sister a haircut. Frame your pictures before you take them with a great new economical Pentax Zoom 60. Make no mistake.
Install a ring, install a ring, install a ring.
For the hottest of hot, hot water you've ever seen.
Ring comes on steady, hot and strong.
When your old heaters had the gong.
Install a ring, install a ring, install a ring.
At the end of the day, which not-so-squeezy truck supplies you with a perfect mix of power, strength and reliability? Mitsubishi Canter. It commands respect.
Wednesday night, Agnes of God. A baby is born in a convent. A baby dies in a convent. Was it murder, a miracle, or both?
No one knew about Agnes's pregnancy. No one, not even Agnes.
A determined woman will move heaven and earth to uncover the truth.
There is more here than meets the eye, isn't there? Lots of dirty little secrets.
Starring Jane Fonda, Anne Bancroft, and Meg Tilly. Brought to you by Singapore Airlines and Bridgestone. The gripping story, Agnes of God, Wednesday, 8:30 on the Nine Network.
Checking the results in New South Wales TAB dividends for Sydney Race 4, the numbers 8, 11 and 4. They were Record Dash, Ladrone and Pleasant Flight, $10.330, $2.10 and $2.50 as you see it there. And John Delar, which was Kenny Callender's tip by the way, is still running. Kenny Callender's tip for Sydney Race 5 is number 2, Stylish Century. And good luck to punters. In VFL news, makes you full...
To Canterbury now in brilliant sunshine for the running of the big one of the day, the Tuohy's Peter Pan Stakes. It carries prize money of $125,000, and this in fact is the 12th running of this particular race, inaugurated in 1978 and won by a very good filly called Carpa Laren, although she is by no means the best horse to ever win the Peter Pan Stakes, because Kenny, my boy, I'm going to throw three names at you as I cross down: Best Western, Kingston Town and Handy Proverb. Not a bad trifecta.
John, I'd like to be back in Kingston Town against this lot. I think we need a record-winning margin. But I've got my cash on Stylish Century, and I'll think he's Kingston Town if he can win this. Let's look at the prices. Number one, Select Prince, is at 7-2, a little bit easy. Stylish Century has now come into 11-4, $3.80 for a dollar. 25-1, Coconut Shy. 20, Vain Promise. Crackenback, a stablemate of Stylish Century, is also at 11-4, $3.90 on the tote. 30-1 Gold Brigand, 8 Party Mood. Number 8 Posolipo is the third Cummings runner. He's at 12-1. He's got a chance too. Solar Circle at 11-1. Storm Alert is one of the roughies at 80-1. Remember Peter at 33-1. Little Trout is at 50-1. Questionnaire, Cool Credit and Headwind, all reserves. They never got runs. Stylish Century has got a bad barrier here, but remember, he ran 1-9 and a tick in winning the Brambles Classic over 1,200. I think he'll get over. Let's see if he does. Here's Johnny.
All set and ready. Select Prince stands well. Jump at any second. Light flashing. Off in the Peter Pan, Select Prince began brilliantly. Stylish Century, on the other hand, missed it altogether and was a clear last out of the barrier. Vain Promise from the inside gate began well, and Crackenback is one of the leaders. Gold Brigand is trapped out very deep early, and now Storm Alert is coming over from the outside, and Stylish Century, set alight by Marshall after a slow start, is rushing around the field. He tries to steady the horse in third place, but Stylish Century is now pulling hard and has the mouth wide open as they go to the back. Cook on Gold Brigand slows them up to lead narrowly over over Storm Alert, and Stylish Sensory on the outside is going to pull his way to the lead at the 1,000 mark. Krakenback is handy, and so is Select Prince between horses. He's starting to pull a bit now. Select Prince, the pace is very muddling in the Peter Pan as they go down the back. Coconut Shy out wide is going up closer to the lead, and then Little Trout and Party Mood, followed by Vain Promise and Posilipo. Solar Circle on the fence is second last, and last of all is Remember Peter as they start the run up the hill. 600 metres out, Stylish Sensory on the outside, and Gold Brigand are going together by a length and a half to Storm Alert, followed by Krakenback and Select Prince, and then Vain Promise and Party Mood between horses being hard ridden as they near the turn, followed by Coconut Shy. Remember Peter taking off right around the field, and then Solar Circle, Posilipo and Little Trout. Into the straight now, Gold Brigand and Stylish Sensory are the two leaders, and they're clear of Storm Alert, running a big race, and then Vain Promise, Party Mood, White Outer starting to run home hard now, and Krakenback is just behind them. Storm Alert tackled by Party Mood. Party Mood on the outside has got them covered. He hit the lead 50 metres out. Dittman throwing everything at him, and Party Mood comes away to win the Peter Pan. Storm Alert second, Krakenback third, fourth, Stylish Sensory, a very big run. So coming home well, Solar Circle, and then Vain Promise, Little Trout, Posilipo. At the head of the others, Coconut Shy, Remember Peter, Gold Brigand, and Select Prince pulled up at the tail of the field, with Wayne Harris looking down to see if something's amiss with Select Prince. Well, I think that's worth a look, Ken. The closing stages of the big one, and a gutsy win to Party Mood. Back to you, Ken, for your observations of the last 100 metres. OK, Party Mood hit the front from Storm Alert, about 100 out, and with Dittman throwing everything at him, although he did ease up right on the line, but he scored a very good win. So it's number 7, Party Mood, $10 and $2.50. Number 10, Storm Alert, $13. And number 5, Krakenback, $1.80. More on Wide World of Sports coming up after this break.
Let's check the results now in New South Wales TAB dividends for Sydney Race 5. First, number 7, Party Mood, as you can see there, $10 and $2.50. Number 10, Storm Alert, was second, $13. And number 5 was third, Krakenback, paying $1.80. Kenny Callender has a tip for Sydney Race 6 now. It's number 5, and the name of the horse, Hunter. Obviously, some of those horses don't like the Canterbury track. OK, VFL News, 5 games are being played this afternoon.
OK, back to Canterbury for Race 6, the Tooheys Draft Premier's Cup. And Nick Greiner himself is a guest of the Sydney Turf Club today. As a matter of fact, we had the pleasure of his company in the commentary box with Sydney Turf Club chairman Mr. Jim Fleming a short time ago. And the Premier was quick to remind me that my tips today have been performing like dromedaries, Ken. A very hurtful and malicious statement.
John, I thought you were going to give him a rap. Yeah, you're mixing with a lot of silver tails up there. It's a wonder you crossed to me. Let's have a look at the field for the Premier's Cup, which is usually called the Canterbury Cup. Number 1, Just Trishes, it's 7-1 getting out to 8-1 now. Copper Tonic at 33-1. Number 3, Mountbank at 60-1. Number 4, Paul Andic out to 9-1. Hunter is favourite, paying $3.10 for a dollar on the tote, bringing him in just over 2-1. He might even come in a fraction more. Number 6, Exceptional Angel at 40-1. Impresetto is at 8-1. Number 8, The Brotherhood at 30-1. Valiant End, gee, that seems fair odds. It's coming a little bit now to 11-1. Still seems a good price. 25, Snow Chief. Port Kingdom is at 11-1. 66, March C. Number 13, Shalia, has firmed another point to 7-1. She's well in commission. And Regal Cella is at 8-1. My tips for Hunter, he's not a very flash price, but I think he'll be hard to beat. Johnny, I think they're nearly all in.
Thanks, Ken. And gee, it's clouding over very threateningly now at Canterbury. Some big black beauties appearing overhead. We've certainly got time to duck down to the Sandown course in Melbourne, where they've had a very wet and miserable day, and the J.J. Liston Stakes, a time-honoured wait-for-age event, was run there a short time ago. You'll recognise some of the names. It was a star-studded field.
Down the outside, Memphis Blues running on with Ingotatus, and Prime Risker's getting a run on the inside, and Cow Rowlett is finishing on pretty well. Anybody's race with 250 to go. My Steely Dan just in front of Cow Rowlett, and Ingotatus down the outside, and Tango Master. It's Cow Rowlett taking the lead with 100 metres left to go. Cow Rowlett's in front of Ingotatus, driving at it. Cow Rowlett just in front. Oh, very tight this. Cow Rowlett on the inside, and Ingotatus hit us locked together. Terrific flew home to be third, probably ahead of Tango.
Yeah, good win by Cairo Ladd, ridden by apprentice B. Fletcher and trained down at beautiful Mornington. But did you spot that old horse, Terrific, rocketing home into third place? That's the horse that absolutely jumped out of the ground. He's a stayer. and 1,400 metres normally far too short, but nice and fresh, he was able to keep in touch, and boy, did he come home. Now, during the Liston Stakes, I've been having a look up here at the starting point, and I noticed that Mick Dittman has dismounted from Impresetto. The horse has been blindfolded. He can give trouble at times. He's got a splash of the rogue in him, Impresetto, when it comes to the starting gates, and he's going to cause some trouble today. The riders of Regal Shalar, Snow Chief, the Brotherhood and Port Kingdom are waiting for Impresetto to be positioned before they move their mounts up. And I would personally love to see Impresetto get in a hell of a hurry and get this field underway for a multitude of reasons. The Premier's Cup, sponsored by TUIs, who've poured a fortune into racing in the city of Sydney in recent years, and of course they apply their sponsorship banner to many of our great races, including the Golden Slipper Stakes. The protest on the previous race was dismissed, third against second, and the placing stood 7, 10 and 5 as they went over the line. The winner being Party Mood, ridden by Mick Dittman. Now, Impresetto is in. Now, Impresetto, blindfolded, has moved into the gates. Dittman is remounting. Snow Chief links up. We're waiting only for Port Kingdom, and they'll be all set and ready for a start in the Premier's Cup. Ready. That protest on the Peter Pan was only a minor one, third against second. Now, Regal Shalar wants to lay sideways in the stall. He's standing a bit splay-footed, Regal Shalar. An attendant gives Johnston a hand, and the gates open. And they're off in the Premier's Cup. Snow Chief on the extreme outside, and Port Kingdom began brilliantly. In fact, they kamikazed out from those wide gates, and they've come straight across to go to the lead together. The Brotherhood is rushing up into third place, followed closely by Copper Tonic and then Hunter. Out deep is March C at the winning post on the outside of Valiant End. And then just Trish and Shelley are followed by Paul Landick, Exceptional Angel, Impresetto. Mountbank is second last, and dropping out last, Regal Shalar as they leave the straight. Now, Snow Chief is the leader, but March C, three deep, is going up quickly now into second spot. Port Kingdom running third on the inside of the Brotherhood, 2.5 lengths then to Copper Tonic, 2.5 to Hunter, and neck to Valiant End being niggled a bit on the outside. A gap then to Just Trish on the outside of Shalia, followed by Paul Landick, Exceptional Angel. Well back Impresetto and Mountbank, and Regal Shalar is last. The field is well spread out, and they're going at a very solid gallop to the 1,000 mark, which will help some of the back markers. And Snow Chief is the leader, March C second, Port Kingdom third, the Brotherhood fourth. A gap of 5 lengths then to Copper Tonic, a length to Hunter in a good spot, followed by Valiant End, who's now being scrubbed along. Hunter wanted to drop the bit at the 800 mark, and Cassidy is starting to heel him along now. Further back, Paul Landick, and then Shalia, Just Trish, Exceptional Angel, followed by Regal Shalar. Impresetto being second last, and dropping out last is Mountbank as they come up the hill. At the 500 mark, and Snow Chief led over March C, Port Kingdom, the Brotherhood. A gap to Copper Tonic and Hunter together, and then Valiant End, followed by Shalia. Well back, Regal Shalar and Impresetto is taking off right around the outside as they turn for home, where Port Kingdom had raced to the lead. Port Kingdom kicked away, turning for home with a good break of 3 lengths on March C, and then Snow Chief and the Brotherhood, followed by Hunter, getting through between horses, and further out Impresetto. Port Kingdom is well clear halfway down the straight over the Brotherhood, and then Hunter and March C, but Port Kingdom is well clear, and he's going to win the Premier's Cup. Port Kingdom kept going to the line, scored well over the Brotherhood and Hunter, and then March C, Paul Landick, Impresetto, Mountbank, Exceptional Angel, Shalia, well back, followed by Copper Tonic, Valiant End, Regal Shalar, Just Trish and Snow Chief, the early leader, has weakened to run last. The winner is Port Kingdom, number 11, tote odds of $12 and $4, number 8 second. The Brotherhood is going to pay $7.50, and third, number 5, Hunter, $1.60, a break, and then more on Wide World of Sports.
Canterbury, first, number 11, Port Kingdom, $12 and $4. Number 8 was second, the Brotherhood paid $7.50. And number 5, the Hunter, third, $1.60. And that, by the way, was Kenny Callender's tip. It still had some catching up to do. The tip now from Kenny Callender for race 7 is number 4, From the Planet. And we wish all the punters good luck this afternoon at Canterbury. Okay, VFL.
Well, to Canterbury Park for the last of our telecast races today. It's the TUI's Concord Stakes over the Hurry Scurry course of 1,000 metres. And not surprisingly, the short price favourite is a little horse from Coffs Harbour by the name of Lightning Bend, who has a remarkable record of 10 wins from 15 starts and his last 8 straight. Ken, he certainly enhances the old adage that good things come in little parcels. He's not much bigger than a kid's pony.
No, John, and who am I to knock him? He's a great little horse. I was even backing him when he won Newcastle Intermediates. But I do think From the Planet will beat him today. My tips haven't been crash hot, but I've let go here. I think this will win. Okay, here are the prices. Number one, Marimbula Bay at 12-1. Lightning Bend is at evens. He's got a great chance. Number three, Mystical Prince is at 80-1. From the Planet is showing $3.80 odds of 11-4. I think he might run over the top of them. I sincerely hope he does. As I look, he's moved out to 3-1. Alpine Flyer at 12-1. Sobers at 8-1. Dewdor is 15-1. Coming Up is 60-1. Classic Hand at 60-1. Mayflower Lad at 50-1. He'll go fast early. I visualise he and Sobers being the two pace setters. 200-1 Royal Jet Setter, who's got a bit of early pace. 100 Flash Fable. 33 Coefficient. And 200-1 Miller Murrah Lad. As I speak, Lightning Bend number two has come into a shade of odds on $1.90 for $1, 10 to 9 on. It's not flash odds, but he's got a great hope. Me, I'm on Hit the Planet. Here's Johnny.
Okay, Ken, From the Planet's been sparingly raced. He's a four-year-old with only 11 starts under his belt for 4 wins, but those wins, or the majority of them, were in Silk Department Company. He's a very good horse. Now, they're about set as the last couple move up and the starter's coming over to climb onto his rostrum and dispatch the field. And there should be great speed on in this race. Some very fast horses engaged. Miller Murrah Lad wide out, stands squarely. So does Royal Jet Setter. Track cleared, starter ready. They'll break it any second. They're off. Alpine Flyer made a mess of the start. He's a clear last out of the barrier. And Mayflower Lad and Sobers began brilliantly. Lightning Bend is fast into stride, followed by Miller Murrah Lad. Royal Jet Setter and Alpine Flyer are next. And out deep is Mystical Prince, even wider Coefficient. And then Marimbula Bay and further back Flash Fable, From the Planet, Classic Hand, and Come on Up. And that's the order as they start the run up the hill. And Dirty Orr can't go the pace, and he's last of all. Sobers in front over Mayflower Lad. Lightning Bend in third place, being ridden a bit. On the fence, Alpine Flyer, a gap to Miller Murrah Lad and Mystical Prince, followed by Royal Jet Setter, Coefficient, Marimbula Bay, and at the head of the others, Flash Fable, From the Planet, is giving them a huge start. Into the straight, and Sobers has dashed away as they turn the corner. In second place, Lightning Bend, and then Alpine Flyer, followed by Mayflower Lad. Sobers starting to feel the pinch. His stablemate, Alpine Flyer, Lightning Bend, hampered slightly, can't pick them up. Alpine Flyer claims Sobers. Alpine Flyer hits the front. Lightning Bend tries his heart out in second place, but can't pick up Alpine Flyer. From the Planet jump out of the ground to get third. Sobers weakened out of it, and then Mystical Prince and Flash Fable, Dirty Orr, Marimbula Bay, Classic Hand, and Come on Up, Coefficient. Then Miller Murrah Lad, followed by Royal Jet Setter, and Mayflower Lad is back with the tail enders in the Concord Stakes. The winner is Alpine Flyer, last out of the barrier and first home. On the tote, $12.80 and 260, 1280 and 260. Second number two, Lightning Bend, will pay $1.30, and number four, From the Planet, to pay $2. And we've got more coming up on Wide World of Sports after this.
I'm going to check the results and the New South Wales TAB dividends for Sydney Race 7 at Canterbury. First across the line, number 5, Alpine Flyer, 1280 and 260. Number 2 was second, Lightning Bend, $1.30. And From the Planet was third, number 4. That was Kenny Callender's tip, by the way. And that picked up $2 on the New South Wales TAB. VFL, 5 matches are being played this afternoon.
$125,000 Peter Pan Stakes at Canterbury, the kickoff to Sydney's Spring Carnival. The track was dead and the favourite Starless Century at 5-2.
Nick Prince is well back out of the race as they swing into the straight, and shortly after Gold Brigand, headed off by Stylish Century. But on the outside, Storm Alert is threatening danger, and down the outside, Party Mood and Krakenback are chiming in. Storm Alert has the lead, but Party Mood goes to Storm Alert at the 50-metre peg, and Party Mood's going to win it, running away. Party Mood has won it. Storm Alert second, Krakenback third, fourth to Stylish Century, and then Vain Promise.
Clear win at the end to Party Mood at 8-1 ahead of Storm Alert. Unplaced favourite, the much fancy Bart Cummings horse, Stylish Century. To raise six now, and the Tui's Premier's Cup.
Entering the last 200, 2.5 to 3 in front of the Brotherhood, giving chase to it, and they're followed by March Sea and Hunter, but Port Kingdom look to have a shot to bits. The Brotherhood is trying hard but can't make it, and Port Kingdom races home to beat the Brotherhood. Hunter third, then March Sea, followed then by Port
Convincing Landing. Win to Port Kingdom at 9-1, the Brotherhood second, the favourite Hunter third at 15-8. To Melbourne now in Sandown, race 5, the JJ Liston Stakes.
Tyrell Ad finishing well, and then came Ingotatus, and the Primaris booting up along the inside. Tyrell Ad, my Steely Dan, Ingotatus coming over the top of them. Tyrell Ad has hit the front, Ingotatus the challenger. Tyrell Ad in front, nearing the line, he's held on. Tyrell Ad won.
A tight finish, Cairo Lad coming home at 5-1 ahead of Ingotatus, unplaced favourite, my Steely Dan.
Corral Lad scored a narrow win in the Liston Stakes at Sandown on a slow track today. Punters had a tough day, but not one favourite winning. Now to results, and the first on the programme won by Princess Pushy, who's lightly raced and scored well, the favourite Concordance out of a place, but was making ground at the finish. Staverdale scored well in race 2, and it started at 8-1, an exciting win by this import, paying 14-1 on the tote. Impressionism took the third for Darren Gauchy at 5-1, proved the Mooney Valley form wrong, and beat the stablemate Marshall into fourth placing at 9-4. Race 4, first leg of the quadrilla now.
The lead, Mrs. Selleck comes again strongly. Ben Barra Queen over the top of them, but Mrs. Selleck has hit the front down on the inside. Ben Barra Queen goes home the best. Mrs. Selleck just in front. Ben Barra Queen grabs her. Ben Barra Queen got up to beat Mrs. Selleck, and Dancer's Choice has probably held on to third.
That the long shot of the day, 33s, paying 68s on the tote, and has now won all three at Sandown. Now the Liston.
Under the whip with about 300 to go. Tango Master, a cheeky race, just the lead of it. My Steely Dan looms alongside. Here's Cairo Lad finishing well, and then came Ingotatus, and the Primaris booting up along the inside. Cairo Lad, My Steely Dan, Ingotatus coming over the top of them. Cairo Lad has hit the front, Ingotatus the challenger. Cairo Lad in front, nearing the line, he's held on. Cairo Lad's won it. From Ingotatus and Torrific splashed home into third placing.
The New Zealand Muddy got the money at fives, but good runs from Torrific and Apollo Run. Now, our watchman in the Gouch.
Sir Trident and our watchman race to the lead together from Hussar's Pick and Hallstrong. Our watchman has taken the lead under the whip. He's drawn away from Sir Trident. Hallstrong finishing well, but our watchman punched out will go on and win it by about a length and a half. Very close second and third. Hallstrong and Sir Trident couldn't separate.
And that completed a double for Darren Gauchy, our watchman, at 5-1. Second leg of the Daily Double.
They're starting to close on Liberty Slipper now. A wall of horses coming home with Undoubted and Fighting Man reaching the lead together. Undoubted and Fighting Man, Undoubted the outside and Fighting Man on the inside. They're going to the line of bobbing finish this. They hit the post. Undoubted, I think, just won. Undoubted from Fighting Man and third Trapine Queen.
Undoubted at 16s, defeated the favourite Fighting Man in a bobbing finish, and Trapine Queen making up ground for third. The last race won by Tights at 14-1 over Bit of Hope, also 14s and Silver Thatch at 8-1. There's the Daily Double, a pair of 8s, 50.05. Extra for numbers 4 and 8, 475.25. The Quaddy, 8848, $7,600 and 50 cents, and the Quad Extra, 848 and 14, $4,813 and 70 cents. And finally, a reminder of the sixth test live.